Okay. Good evening, everybody. I'm welcoming all the audience and participants for today's session. We are doing that today, 5 p.m. We are having, once again, we are having one speaker that very much familiar with us, that is our Dr. Suman Sarkar. Actually, he was familiar because he was the faculty of Shalatantra department in Bille Sankarpur Rajiv Gandhi Ayurveda Medical College and Hospital. But recently, he is a medical officer with the special in charge in Shalashutra department at Shamadash Vaidya Shastrapeeth and Institute of Ayurvedic Education and Research in Kolkata. So today, his concept of Ayurveda, way of understanding. So warm-heartedly, I'm to start his presentation towards our audience.
Good evening, everybody. Today, first of all, I thank Dr. Priyanka and his teammates for giving me a chance for this presentation. Today, I will telling about Garbhudha cancer. That is our concept of Ayurveda in according to the Garbhudha. Okay. Priyanka, you can go to the presentation slide.
Yes, sir. I'm just going to show the presentation. Yes.
Today we are discussing about the Garbhudha. That is Ayurvedic way. How we can learn, how can we understand Garbhudha in our methodology. So, second slide. So, Garbhudha it consists of two words. That is, one is Arva and one other is Uditi. Arva means the word Arva denotes that to kill, and Uditi means to elevate it or to rise. Garbhudha is a numerical word which means 100 millions, which is due to the uncontrolled proliferation of the cells. So why this proliferation? The proliferation is due to the loss of response to the normal growth cells. Why there is loss of response to the normal growth? Due to the damage to the genes, mainly to the oncogenes. The oncogenes, because it is due to the exposure to the carcinogen. Okay, next slide. Let's comes with the sign and symptom of the Garbhudha. We know that the shloka is very much familiar to it us, that is Gatra Poreshe Koshchit Dosha Sangmurchita Mangsham Abhi Purusha Vittam Sirang Mandarujang Mahantam Analpa Mulam Ananpa Mulam the Poreshe Koshchit Dosha Sangmurchita Mangsham Abhi Purusha means they are the pathogenesis of the diseases. And last four three lines is the sign and symptom of the doshas. So when there is vitiation of the dosha, next slide. When there is vitiation of the dosha. When there is vitiation of the dosha, it can go anywhere in the body parts, where it damages the muscular connective tissue along with the connective endothelial cells and causing the Garbhudha. So what is the sign and symptom? That is Vittam Sthiram, that is the growth is round and stony hard, and Mandarujam is the pain is not present, except the pain can be seen in the final stage of the our disease, Garbhudha, or cancer. Next is Mahantam Ananpa Mulam. It's placed with the deep root, means the cancer is fixed with the deeper structures. And Chiravidhi means it is chronic in nature and gradually in progress. Apakam means it is non-suppurative. and Mangshong Upochoy is the unnecessary and uncontrolled abnormal proliferation of the tissue. So what is the Orbuda? Next slide. So what is Orbuda? It is a deep but palpable tumor which is fixed to the underlying structure. Look, no, next come to our etiology or nidan. It is very much familiar with the Shofu and Granthi. Shofu is the universal swelling. Where is the Granthi? It varies from the size according to the Bhagavata. So both Shofu and Granthi, both are the cause of, as similar cause of the Orbuda. They are the precursor or predominant syndrome of the Orbuda. Hari Sangeeta mentioned as a special etiology, that is, if there is any trauma or abhigata, it causes damage to the self, which gone by the Rakhranane and Purishin Shango elsewhere in the body. So and contouring and forming a Orbuda in elsewhere of the body. So coming to the step of the pathogenesis. According to pathogenesis, we can classify the Orbuda in three stages. That is Shofu, Granthi and Orbuda. In first stage, we can see the Shofu, that is the universal swelling. Thereafter, Granthi means there is some elongated or nobular structure can be seen. After that, Orbuda comes. First, three or four is the Shaddha, that is Bhattaja, Pittaja, Kaphaja and Medhaja, that is benign state. And Raktaja and Medhaja, Raktaja and Mangshaja is the Ashaddha state. And when it is metastasis, we can call it Ardha Arbud or Pre-Arbud. Ardha Arbud is nothing but when it is growth over the pre-existing one. And Pre-Arbuda is the when both simultaneously one after the another. So come to the Kriyakala, next slide. So in a word, we can definition the Kriyakala as a Sanchay, Proko, Kosher, Transanchay, Bhakti and Ved. Sanchay is the localization of the dose. Prokop is the acceleration. Koshar is the spread. Sthansangshay is the embolization. And Bhakti is the reaction and Bhed is the chronicity. Slide not coming, no? Again, slide is not coming.
Yes, sir. Once again, sir. Sir, is it visible now?
No, okay, next slide.
Yes.
So, we come to the Samprapti Ghatakatta. So what is the dosha? The main dosha is the Kapha and Vata. And it may be associated with the three dosha. The dusha is the Mangsha, Meda, Rakta. Choto is Chotodushti, mainly the Shanga. And sometimes it is causing the Shira Granthi. In here, always there is the Mandarini there. And Rogamarga is the Bajya Rogamarga. It can be situated anywhere in the body. And in the skin, it is situated in the Rohini layer. And the main symptom is Mangshong Pocheram to Shofam. Means there is the elongation of the connective tissue with the epithelial tissue. Next slide. So next come to the classification of the Orbuda. We can divide in two parts. According to dosha, it is mainly six types: Vata, Pitta, Kapha, Rakta, Mangsha and Meda, according to Sushruta. But if we divide it in two parts according to dosha and dosha, we can see Vata, Pitta, Kapha, Didosha and Sandipata is mentioned in the Bhagavata. Whereas Rakta, Mangsha and Meda has been mentioned by Sushruta, and Oshti Orbuda is mentioned in the Bhagavakasha. Okay, come next slide. So let's come to the sign and symptom of the specific Vishishta Lakshan. So why this pathogen? Because there is stretching of the tissue due to the carcinogenic cell. So there are pain in pathogen case, there will be stretching type of pain, picking type of pain, and throbbing, cutting type of pain, and it will be black in nature, and it is characterized by bladder distended with ear, with rough and elongated. In Pitta Jal, there will be associated, when they are stretching, there will be associated with the inflammation. So there will be the burning, in burning sensation, boiling sensation, suckling sensation is like that. So the color obviously will be the red and yellow, but there will be no suppuration. Again, not coming. In metatarsal, there will be slight and painful with excessive itching, and there will be, it will be bigger in size, and it will be decreasing the swelling according to the size of the body. Let's come with the benign condition, treatment of the benign disc condition. In Bataja, we are giving the Uponaho, then then Nourisher, and then Singo to immobilize our cell consistency, so the pain will be less. In Pittaja condition, we are giving mild Shedan, Uponaho, Birechan, Lepon, and Raktamakkhan. In Kaphaja condition, we are giving Snehan, Shedan, Gaman, Birechan, Lepon, Raktamakkhan, Magatrapi, Agnikarma, Kharkama, etc. Because in Kaphaja, the tissue is densely in the capsule, which is confined, along with there with the itching sensation. So we have to neutralize this dense tissue. So Kharkama, Agnikarma, all should be done. In Medaja, we are giving Shedan, Bidaran, Shodan, and Sivan. That is namely, we have to cut the lipofat tissue, and then we have to remove it with the elongated, with the capsule. Thereafter, we have to suture it. Okay, next slide. So, the Ashadha, that is the carcinogenic state, we can classify it in Mangshaja and Raktaja or both. Mangshaja is Obhighat, it is due to the Obhighat. There is the swelling affected the Mangsha, characterized by the painless, glossy, non-suppurative, stony hard, immobile, with normal color. And in Raktaja, there will be the Visheshan of the dosha, which is caused by the Rujila Vahashira, and there will be no suppuration, and there will be muscular lump, and the main thing is there will be touching bleeding, that is Mangshanku, that's stress, angiogenesis will be occur, that's why there will, when we touch it, there will be severe bleeding. Okay, next slide. So other Orbuda, what is the other Orbuda? We have known the Nasha Orbuda, there is Jiva Orbuda is there, Posha Orbuda also there, in fact, that is the throat cancer. On that, the Rakta Orbuda is the Ashadha, Jala Orbuda can be started at the mucosal cyst, is Shadha. Other is Gala Orbuda, Dala Orbuda, Karna Orbuda also is there. So in a word, next slide. We can classify the manifestation of disease in, that is due to etiology, there is those dushya sammuchana who is causing the cancerous or metastatic states. Okay, next slide. So how we can classify it? We can classify it in our understanding, we can GI malignancy, we can classify it in Gulma, Asha, or Bidradi. In the GI gastrointestinal tract, the main inner lining, there will be bidari causing the cancer. What is, when the lumen is bulging out, that is from the inner side, it will be the gulma. When it is out, when it is inner side, there will be the archer. And when the lumen of the GI tract is bulging outside, that is a gulma. Gulma, it may be palpable or not. When it is palpable, it is known as axial gulma. When it is not palpable, it is known as appointed gulma. Next slide. In respiratory tract, we can can be correlated with the Khatojar Khoyal Kasham, Rajakha. The treatment which is mentioned on there, we can give it on the respiratory tract malignancy. Next slide. In the hepatic malignancy, we can see the Pandu spectrum of disease. There is a lot of disease related to the on that variety. We can see the CRP, ESR all be high in account. With this, there will be the less in hemoglobin. We have to treat the hidden infection first. For that, we have to give some our medicine which is related to the Jokrit and Pliha. It will affect with very much. Next slide. So our aim of the treatment is mainly the Samprapti Vighatan. So the main pathogenesis of the disease, we have to, when it is shorter stage, we have to treat the shorter. When it is the urbuda or benign stage, we have to do acronym treatment. If it is benign, it is better for the surgery, that is previously mentioned. Means after lekhan and session, we have to go for the Shivanakarma. And when it is Ashadha, that is Raktaja Mangshaja, we go for the Vyadhi Vipritam Oshudham. And in if it is chronic stage, we better go for the palliative care. That is the Roshan therapy and else. Okay, next slide. So in the we can see what is the basis of chikitsa. We can again subdivide in two parts. One is Bajra. That is the there is six or seven Bajra. There is a lot of Bajra treatment. Some of them is given in here. That is the Shedana. So when we go for the Shedana treatment, when it is the Ruja Dharu, means when it is indurated, when it is painful, we go, and when it is the hard, we go for Shedana because it loses the tissue. It helps to come out. Then we go for the Lepana. So when we go for the Lepana, in which condition? Means early stage of the inflammation. That is mentioned as a shock of uttita matra issue. This when just inflammation started. And just when at beginning of the disease, we have go for the Lepana. And when we go for the Upanaha, we go for the arm and Vidagdha state. Means, not arm and supporting condition. In between, we then go for the arm and Vidagdha state. And when we go for the Bimla Panchikrishya, that is Shiranang Sujatang Manda, means when it is fixed to the deeper structure and it is painful, we can go for the Bimlapan. The Bimlapan is nothing but a gently massage by the finger. Means it loses the tissue. And Pachan, we have to go for the Pachana when for induction of the suppuration, means we have to make it the Vidagdha stage to pass come out. Pachana, generally this all this Bajra treatment is indicated in the benign conditions. And Abandhan Chikisha, well, Baman is that is the Shadhan and Shaman Chikisha. When Shadhan Chikisha is go for Baman, first Shaman is Shadhan is Baman, Birechan and Raktamaka. Baman is done when it is that Ushanna Mangsha Shokam. Baman is done when there is ulcerative lesion, when ulcerative granulation tissue is been shown. Means granulation tissue is poured out outside. We can go for the Mangsha. This toxin will be liberated out. When we go for the Virechana, in Virechana is generally done in chronic state. Means when the it is very much old in nature, chronic in nature, we can go for the Virechana. And generally the Raktamakkhana is go when there is excessive pain to reduce the pain, and when the toxin is accumulated in much in the cellular tissue, we can go for the Raktamakkhana. Jalokha or any is always very preferable in this condition. And Shamana, we are go for the Agnidipana, Ampachana, Shota Shodan, Roshayan, and Patha. Patha is another is very informative in nature because we during the cancer stage we have always maintained the Patha. It should be loku in R. Next slide. So other treatment is the shalya karma. That is shalya karma is generally done in benign condition. That is after merojagranthi or merojagranthi like that. We have to go for the shedan, lekhan, and shivan karma. That is the shastra karma. And after that, we have to, if that pain is much more there or kafar would there, we can go for the agni karma, khar karma, and jalu karma. And other treatment is followed as when the disease is in which condition. If it is look like shapa, we can go for the shapa treatment. If it is look like the granthi, we can go for the granthi treatment. If it is looks like the bidrari or ulcerative, we can go for the bidrari bot treatment. So let's come to the medicinal part. Which type of medicine we can generally prefer? This part is much more important in our perspective. We have to, which medicine we will go in which condition, it is much more important. Generally, all the rasa ushadhi is given in inflammatory conditions. It generally inhibits the signaling of the vasoendothelial growth factor and also decrease the angiogenesis. It also reduces the inflammation. Generally, the rasa parpati or rasa sindur is generally this type of medicine is generally given in the liver or spleen carcinoma. In rasa parpati, we know the doses. When we generally avoid the salt and excessive water diet, we will go for the dodhi-takro diet on this on that condition. Because it is mainly in cirrhosis condition here, general SITs or cirrhosis, we are giving the rasa parpati. Tamravasya or tamra parpati or tamra sindur, all are given in mainly the gallbladder carcinoma. Also in shamratrama, it can be given in any other also in various condition also. Generally, when the cancer is associated with the lot of hikka, it is generally seen because there is irritation in the phrenic nerve due to the irritation in the diaphragm, we see the hiccup. On that, we have to go for that tamravasya with the lemon juice. When there is the GI manifestation, when the cancer is with the GI manifestation, we can go for the shoot and madhu. When spleen is involved, we can go with the punanava. When gallbladder is involved, we generally with the go for the potal muladi kashai. When it is associated with the prostate or abdominal tumor, we can go with the kumari asham. In tamra parpati also in the skin, you can also use any the previous slide. Tamra parpati is generally used in the skin condition, that is the leukoderma. All this condition we can use. And Vijay parpati is generally used in Vata Pitta condition. Generally it is used in the liver disease, gallbladder disease, and severe colicky pain. It also very helpful when it is much more ascites is there. We can use it in the Baddhaman Matta also. The most common phenomenal name is in our name is Hiragvasya. Hiragvasya is associated with the Shannavasya or Ropavasya. It is generally used in various type of carcinoma. If there is much more inflammation, we can use it with the Ropavasya also. Rasha Gandhi, Rasha Shindu previously said that it is generally in the breast carcinoma, or it can be also used in the skin conditions. Generally, where the CRP is much more high, we are generally use the Rasha Shindu. Rasha Gandhi Mechu Park is another is a Shishidha medicine. It is part of Gandhak, Rasha Korpur, Harita, Kantalogur, Kuthak, Rasha Manikko, all are used in the Rasha Gandhi Mechu Park. it is generally given in 180 mg twice a day. Generally, when this medicine will going on, there the person should not be bath. After 7 or 8 days, he can stop the medicine and take a bath again. Then it will be continued for 41 days. This is a type of our chemotherapy like proformin. It can be increased in it can be in Bardhaman Matra according to the condition of the patient. And another is Chandra Marutam Syndrome. Aritrosham is also used in various type of carcinoma. There is another Orchestra Ross is there, which is used in the pancreatic CA. And Gulma Kutha Ross also is in the uterine carcinoma. There is also Bangavasho and Nagvasho is also used in the BPH. When there will be pain with BPH in the prostatic carcinoma, Nagvasho is added with the Bangavasho. Okay, next slide. So previously we discussing about the Rasha Ushi. Now we come to the herbal preparation. The much more familiar with us is the Phalatak Rasayana. Generally this Phalatak Rasayana we are giving in Vardhaman Matra. We know that Phalatak is 10 types we can use. That is Phalatak Toilo can be used, Phalatak Dudho can be used, Phalatak Dhito can be used. In my practice, I generally prefer Phalatak Thiropak. Means I generally prefer we giving the Phalatak Rasayana as a Vardhaman Matra. First we have to go for the Phalatak Shadana. After Phalatak Shadana, boil with Dugdha in Vardhaman Matra up to 10 days. We give it in Vardhaman Matra. Thereafter 10 to 21 days we are giving in the same polymerase. Means first day we are giving one Phalatak, second day we are giving two Phalatak. 10 days we are giving 10 Phalatak. From 10 to 21 days we are giving 10 Phalatak each day. After 20 days we are decreasing the dose. Means 21 days there will be 9 Phalatak, 22 days there will be 8 Phalatak, 23 days there will be 7 Phalatak. Like this it will be going on. And when the Phalatak Rasayana we are giving, we are giving first, after giving 1 month treatment, we rest for 1 month. Again, second month, we are giving the Phalatak Rasayana. After that, we rest for 2 months. Then after 3 months, we are giving same Phalatak Rasayana. In this way, we get a lot of good results in rectal carcinoma, in throat carcinoma. Generally, much more patient has long life good. More than 4 to 5 years, it is generally going on with this type of Rasayana. After 6 months, we continue one Phalatak Rasayana of this type of patients. Shilajit Rasayana, we are preferring mainly in the BHP patients, benign prostatic hypertrophy patient and prostatic carcinoma. In prostatic carcinoma, we can give it Gugul Bhavitang Shilajit or Gomutta Bhavitang Shilajit. In this condition, Shilajit is giving in the 14 days or 21 days regimen. Means first 3 days, we are giving Shilajit Rasayana at 25 gram morning and evening. In our book, it is mentioned you have to give in single dose. But our Agni is very much mandar. So we cannot consume so much Shilajit in morning. So it is better to give in two morning and evening at 25 gram each. It is on that we have for first 3 days we are Shilajit Rasayana we are giving with Tifala. Thereafter we are giving with the Joshimudu Kashay. Next 3 days we are giving with the Potal Muladi Kashay, and last 3 days we are giving with the Boronadi Kashay. We can follow the same regimen. 7, 14 or 21 days, as mentioned in our book. Pipali Rasayana is generally preferred our in the respiratory tract of infection or in lung carcinoma. we are giving the people Russian. We are not a Burman people. Those is as we know. Gomotto Hoitaki also we have to give in Burman Matra. Generally in the SIPs or Udar Rakh cancer, we are preferring the Gomotto Hoitaki. If we started, we generally increase the dose up to 10 days. Thereafter 10 to 20 days, we have to maintain the doses. After 21 days, we have to just reduce the dose. Saribhadra Shab and Kumariya Shab also is very much familiar with us. It is generally given in BPH with additional Tamravasya or Loknath Rosh or Gangavasya. Next slide. There is a lot of question also is there. Some are given below. That is Boronari Kashay is generally given in the BPH. Gugul Tikta Kashay also given in the skin carcinoma. Tuentary Kashay also is given in the GI tract cancer. Gugul or Kanchana Gugul is very much we know. We are giving it in the any type of cancer. Matikta Ghito, Karanjo Ghito, Panchayikta Ghito. We are also giving for SNM before sudden treatment. Okay, next slide. There is a lot of herbs which can help in carcinoma. A lot of study has been given. Generally, Guruchi, Togol, Lajjalu, Bivitok, Loshun, Garavi, lot of Koshuni Ajwan, Datura, Nirgundi, Kadambo. There are lot of herbs is there which is given, which is used for the cancer treatment. Next slide. Generally, the Ashwagandha has been enhancing the cellular response. Generally, it stimulates the P53 tumor necrosis factors. Whereas the turmeric, that is curcumin, blocks the NF-kappa-B, which uncontrolled and multiplication of the cell has been arrested. Tripala also is very much familiar with us, which helps to prevent the angiogenesis. Gala is the natural source of anti-angiogenesis also. Ashwagandha also blocks the newer blood vessels. Guruchi is arresting the abnormal cellular growth. Okay, next slide. Manjistha has a mild anti-neoplastic activity. It mainly acts in the uterine and ovarian carcinoma. Shatavari has anti-carcinogenic effect and it mainly reduces the epidermal carcinoma of the nasopharynx. Nimbo also has the chemoprotective actions and also help in the gastric CA, hepatic CA and extrahepatic site also. It can be very... Next slide. Generally, our herbal medicine or our medicine generally helps change the cancer surrounding area which the cancer cell cannot be multiplicated. So which the abnormal proliferation, which abnormal proliferation is occurring, it helps to arrest the growth. Mainly the angiogenesis is obstructed by our treatment. There are lot of study has been done regarding next slide. Some are given below. Next slide. That is, you know that Nayantara is much more familiar. We know that vincristine is used for the chemotherapy. It blocks the tubulin binding M-phase, which helps in the which arrests our growth of the multiple division of the cells. It generally arrests the M-phase stage of the carcinic stage. It also helps in against leukemia and nephroblastoma. There is another, is one as Almeria. Next slide. Almeria, it is also as known as golden trumpet. You are very much familiar with this disease, this picture. It also helps in cancer treatment. The mainly this type of the alkaloid has been extracted and is used in cancer treatment. It also arrests and infest. It generally helps in experimental study in lymphocytic leukemia in the mice. It has been shown in good results. Next slide. It is also one type of dengue. The main principle is the constituent is the Wellington lutein alpigene, which mainly suppresses the prostate cancer. Has been known, has been seen that it arrests the growth of the prostate carcinoma. Mainly, it arrests in the signaling pathway. Next slide. We also known as the ginger lily. It also help in the it shown good result in the lung carcinoma induced rat. The principal component is the poronin D. It mainly inhibit the action of the necrophage factor CAVA. Next slide. So in a word, we just conclude our talk. Main the most superficial level we can treat like this. When there is severe cancer pain, we can go for pain due to cancer. We can go for the Rashagandhi Mejupak, Somnath Tamro, Tamramandu, or Chandamol Sindhuram. So generally, in the pain condition, we also use the Nagvarsha along with the Bangavarsha to treat these conditions. In anemia, we generally prefer Lohavarsha, Mandurvarsha, Aprakvarsha, Hiragvarsha, Siddha Makhadas to treat the disease. Generally, in this condition, we can see that the CRP is much more high, whereas the hemoglobin will be low. On this condition, we can go for this type of Varsha preparation, which helps to improve the anemia. Generally, we find very good results within 1 to 2 months. Next slide. To remove the side effect of the chemotherapy, Rasayana Aushadhi is very much effective. Generally, we prefer the Guruchi, Haritaki, Bibetaki, Amlaki, Nimba, Chirota, Tulsi, Raktarohita, Kumari, Shariba, Manjishta. We are preferring this type of medicine. Kumari and Guruchi is more familiar. We are using very much after chemotherapy treatment. For excessive vomiting, where Dakkari Kasha is generally used, when there is a nodule, there we can go for the Shahadevi, Guruchi, Foot, Horiteki, Lake, or Gomutta. Means if there is, we can go for the Viragda state, we can go for the Kifala Gomutta Lake. And if we go for the Ama, we don't go for the Viragda state, we can back to the Ama Avastha, we can go for the Guruchi Lake. It also helps to make it in the same condition. Next slide. When there is morphine induced constipation is there, because we know morphine is much more given in the later stage of carcinoma when there will be severe constipation is there, because due to reduce the pain, modern treatment is using the morphine to diminish the pain condition of the patient. On that condition, we can go for the mismatch to reduce that condition of the morphine-induced constipation. And there is another, mucositis is also very much common. On that condition, we can go for the radiation-induced mucositis. We can go for the shotodotohita, that is the externally. And to prevent the recurrence of the carcinoma, that is much more important, we can go tell the patient to take Tulsi, Dr. Rohitak, Ashwatta, Udumbar, Guruchi, Shomanjan, all are Russian type of medicine. Generally, after chemotherapy or if the cancer is removed, we have to tell the patient to take this medicine at a 1 month or 2 month interval regularly. Okay, next slide. Generally, the medicine which is very used for the prevention of cancer are the kushtha, aragbad, gorochana, bhalata, roshun, raktarohitak, shariba, monjishta, boru, nimbo. There are a lot of medicine is there which is very much helpful. Previously, we have discussed roshun also. We can use as a roshun kiropak in Bardhaman Matra for dying for cancer stage. All this medicine we can use for maintenance of the and good health of the cancer patient. Next slide. Okay. Thank you. If any question, you can ask.
Anybody is having any queries, they may ask the question directly to sir. If anybody is having any question, they may ask the question. Sir, I'm having one question.
In case of
prostate cancer, if due to the exposure of radiation, whenever the proctitis is occurring, in that cases, what would be the actual treatment?
If proctitis will be there, we go for the herbal preparation. If the radiation has already done, in prostate cancer, we can divide in two parts. One is if it go for the modern therapy, and one patient that not gone for the modern therapy. If not gone for the modern therapy, we can go for Gomutra Shabita Shilajit or Gugultito Shilajit as a Russian matter. This Shilajit we have to go in the much more quantity, that is near about 50 gram in mark. But when after radiation, you just tell it radiation, we can go for the kashaya, mainly the tikala kashaya. Money means it should be in shambho in nature, not means it. We don't prefer the bonadi kashaya. We have to prefer dakkadi kashaya, amlakadi kashaya, and tuantadi kashaya. In this type of medicine, we are giving for after radiation, that is which is shambho in nature.
Okay, so bonadi kashaya is not recommended in that cases.
No, bonadi kashaya has local lekan property. We can go with the bhubhuti kushilaji. So if we give under condition, it's exacerbate the condition.
Okay sir. And for application, I mean external application, which oil would be better for that?
Which type of carcinoma?
In case of prostate cancer, whenever the proctitis is occurring due to the exposure of radiation in some cases, so which kind of oil would be better?
Gita is commonly used. Shatadhauta Gita is better.
Yes,
very much effective.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, sir, for your very informative and very very beautiful presentation for our all participants. So, anybody still having any question, they may ask. Otherwise, we are going to stop this program now only because 7 p.m. again we are having another speaker. So, thank you so much, sir. Thank you for coming here. And 7 p.m. again will be here. And that time, Dr. Sulabhna Bose, she will be presenting the topic, coronavirus effect on manasik swastha of an individual. So for some 1 hour, we will take some, break. And afterwards, again, we will be coming. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, sir. And all the participants.
Okay.
Namaskar.